chapter-wise list of all my videos is available at this point. For DVD, pen drive, please write an email to me. These videos, they do not require internet, they play offline, there is no problem of buffering. And please subscribe to my channel for regular updates. Thank you for your support once again. As told to me by the students, this question was asked in SBI PO 2016 mains exam. Now I will solve this question for you so that you can understand what type of questions are being asked and how to solve those questions. This will also help you gain confidence that these questions can be solved on a single page in a small space. And also, this is one of the best questions to explain sitting arrangement questions that are being asked in the contemporary, in the current scenario. This question is not tough, it's not easy also, but it is not very difficult because questions difficult than this have been asked in the previous years. So as compared to them, this is a degree lower and this will help you understand the basic thing how to solve sitting arrangement questions. You can pause the video and read the whole statement first. So I'll straightway start solving it. There are two parallel rows of 6 seats each. So let us first of all draw those 6 seats, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And this is the other row, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. A, B, C, D and E are sitting in row 1, so we can call this row 1, which and they are facing south, so they are all facing in the downward direction. P, Q, R, S, T are facing north, so all persons sitting in this row are facing in the north direction. One seat is vacant in each row. So this is the twist in this question. Such thing was never seen earlier, but this is a welcome twist because it won't pose much of a problem for us. Each likes a different color, that is red, green, pink, blue, purple, white, black and gray and violet and yellow. Various colors have been given to us. These colors are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This means 5 persons on one side have 5 colors. 5 persons on the other side have another 5 colors, 10 persons, 10 colors. And one seat is vacant in each row. This means there is no person there and there is no color also there. So this simplifies things for us a bit. The best way to solve such types of questions is to peacefully and slowly read each condition, each one by one, and collect as much of exact information as is possible and keep on reading each statement pass by pass. Read all once, put information that is concrete here, then read again, evaluate and then improve upon this. This way the solution comes very easily. Let us start. S sits third to the right of R. Now we already know that S and all are sitting on this row. S sits third to the right of R. This means the story could be like this. R space space S. Only two people sit between Q and the vacant seat. This means Q is also in the lower row. So we have either a possibility like I'll mark vacant seats by X. This is the possibility, or X space space Q. They haven't said who is to the right or left. So we have these two possibilities that are at present possible. Next he says we have consumed this one so we can temporarily tick it mark. Q doesn't like purple or pink color. This we can skip right now. E is not an immediate neighbor of C. We don't know where is C, so nothing of that sort is also possible. B likes yellow color. We don't know where is B sitting. This can be tackled later. The one who likes pink faces the one who likes gray. Absolutely nothing to be done for this also. The one who likes pink sits opposite to the one who sits third right of the person who sits opposite to S. We don't know the position of S also. So nothing can be done for this yet. C is not an immediate neighbor of D. Of course, no information. T who likes neither purple nor white doesn't face the vacant seat. Still nothing can't be done about this also. Don't worry, something will come. Neither S nor R sits any of the extreme ends. Now this is interesting. S and R, they do not sit at extreme ends. This means you will have one person to the left of S and one person to the right of S. Because total places are 6. So we will have R in between, S in between with one person to this side and one to this side. Now this is finalized. So let us fix them. So those I am finalizing, I'll write here R, two spaces S. And he has also said D faces R. So this makes things very interesting. We can put D also straight away. So eighth condition is consumed. I know that in your examination you won't have the ability to tick mark them, but for the purposes of explaining you and cutting short the video time, I am just ticking mark them so that I don't read them over and over again. Vacant seats are not opposite to each other. Nothing can be done. Two persons sit between C and B. Who sits third right of the one who likes black color? Let us see what can be done about this one. Two persons sit between C and B. So he says the story is either like this or it is like this. Okay, I'll just cross this one because this is no longer required. So whatever is not required, I'll keep removing so that things don't clutter. Two persons sit between C and B. Who sits third right of the one who likes black color? Now C and B, they belong to row 1. So if B is to sit to the right of anybody and third right, that means that that person should be sitting at this place. Now is it possible? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is not possible. This means that B cannot have that person to the right side if this condition is to be met. Let us take about this one. He says B sits third to the right of the person who likes black color. This means C, if C is on this side, then B will obviously come third to the right of C because C is facing downwards. So this means this is not the possibility. This is the possibility B space space C and C likes black color. So black will tell later on. So this is one thing that we have crystallized so far. So far I have these two. This is one of these is possible. This is one possibility and this is what I have right now. Okay, let us move on to the next condition. The one who likes violet color faces the one who likes blue color. We have nothing known about these colors. Can't do anything about it. The persons who like red and gray are adjacent to each other. Nothing can't be done yet. The vacant seat of row 1 is not an immediate neighbor of D. So we can't yet do anything about it. Q sits at one of the extreme ends. R does not like red and gray color. Take about this one. Q sits at one of the extreme ends. Now this chain and this chain will now crystallize. So this means either Q, either the story is Q space space X, that is R will be here of course, or it is the other way round, Q starting from this position space space X. This means if Q is at this end, then vacant position will be here. If Q is at the right end, vacant position will be here. We just keep it in our records right now. And remove this one because this we have already taken to the other side. R does not like red or gray colors. No, nothing to do about it right now. Vacant seat of row 1 does not face S, who doesn't sit at any of the extreme ends. We already know that S is not at any extreme end, and vacant seat cannot come of this row, cannot come here. So we'll wait for the second pass. Now at the end of the first pass, what we have is B space space C is a possibility, Q X X Q R S D. So this is the picture that we have at the end of the first pass. Let us now start making the second pass. Q doesn't like purple or pink, nothing about to be done. E is not an immediate neighbor of C, E hasn't yet been placed, so we still can't do anything about it. Because we are dealing with D, R, S, Q, X and B and C, so E is not in picture yet, we'll have to still wait for that. B likes yellow color, this is interesting, so B likes yellow, so I'll write here yell. That will tell me that B likes yellow color, so I can keep it for my records for present. The one who likes pink faces the one who likes gray color. Now that also we don't know anything. The one who likes pink sits opposite to the one who sits third right of the person who sits opposite to S. A bit jumbling, but we can, I think, work with it because S is fixed. He says the one who likes pink sits opposite to the one who sits third right of the person who sits opposite to S. Let us see who is sitting opposite to S. This person is sitting opposite to S. And the third right of this will be third right 1 to D. That is going to be D. He says third right of the person who sits pink is liked by somebody who sits opposite to this. So this means R likes pink. This pink is sitting opposite to the person who is third right to the person who is sitting opposite to S. Just a roundabout way of saying the things. Basically this entire thing says that R likes pink color. So this probably we have settled. C is not an immediate neighbor of D. Let us see. Now this one will bring something interesting for us. It means he says C is not an immediate neighbor of D. This means C is not here, not here. Now if C can't be in the first three positions, not here, D is already there, not here. C can't be in the first three. And after this there are three. This obviously means that C has to be at the corner. And if C is placed at this position, then B will come at this position. Because C has three persons to the left and C can't be in the first three, so obviously C has to be at the corner. And B likes yellow, so I'll write yell here to remind me that B likes yellow color. So I'll remove this. This is already consumed. So I have now finalized C, B, D, R, S. Let us move to our next statement, what they say. So I have consumed the sixth statement, I'll mark it first. Then he says T who likes neither purple nor white doesn't face the vacant seat. Now I don't know which is vacant, so that can't be done anything about this. To ninth, vacant seats are not opposite to each other. I don't know where is the vacant seat of that one and of this one, so nothing can't be done yet. Two persons sit between C and B who sits third right of the one who likes black color. This means C likes black color. Third right of the one who likes black color. So C is liking black color. I can consume this one. The one who likes violet color faces the one who likes blue color. I have no idea who likes blue color and nothing about violet so far. So we'll go to the next one. The persons who like red and grey colors are adjacent to each other. No idea. Vacant seat of 1 is not an immediate neighbor of D. So let us see whether we can consume. Vacant seat can't come here. Vacant seat can come either here or here. So I'll for temporarily mark a small x here and small x here because these are the only two places where vacant seat can come. Vacant seat of row 1 is not an immediate neighbor of D. This means vacant can't be at this position. Q sits at one of the extreme ends. R does not like red and gray color. R doesn't like red and gray color. We can't do anything about it right now because he likes pink is already known to us. Vacant seat of row 1 does not face S. So this vacant seat cannot come opposite to S. This means vacant seat will have to come at this position, which is finalized. Remove this, remove this. So my 15th is already consumed. And let us now again make another pass. Things will crystallize. Q doesn't like purple or pink. Wait for it, because Q is not seated right now. E is not an immediate neighbor of C, and B likes yellow color. E is not an immediate neighbor of C. This means E cannot come at this position. E will obviously have to come on this position. So stories are finalized, and I think A is left and we can easily paste A at this position. So where were we? Third has been finally consumed. Now he says the one who likes pink faces the one who likes gray color. So this is pink and this D must obviously like gray color because they are said to be opposite to each other. So I was here, the one who likes pink faces the one who likes gray color. This is also consumed. Now seventh, T who likes neither purple nor white doesn't face the vacant seat. T will not face the vacant seat. This means Q is known to come at this position. R is already here. Now T is either at this end or at this or at these two places. T doesn't face the vacant seat. This means T can't be here. T is either at this spot or at this spot or at this spot, depending on how the Q and all they are placed. So these three possibilities are for T, because if Q is switched to this side, then T will come here. T will therefore come at this position or here. T cannot come opposite to this. T can't come here because these two are already occupied and this is vacant, it is forbidden. So the remaining three are possibilities for T right now. So we can say this is also consumed for our purposes. Now, vacant seats are not opposite to each other. This means X was coming at either of these positions. There, X can't come here because of this condition now, because they can't be opposite to each other. So this brings a grand placement of X and Q, because X could come either here or here, and now X cannot come opposite to X. So X comes here and spaces, and Q comes at this position. This means I have consumed this also and consumed this also. Now with this, another thing has happened. Because X is lying here, so T can't come there because X is already there. Q is already filling, T can't go there. This means T will have to come to this position, and P was left in this, so I'll put P. So the interesting development that has taken so far is that at this, especially this last point, is that I have now placed every person. Only colors need to be placed, removing this one because already settled. So ninth is also consumed. The one who likes violet color faces the one who likes blue color. Now there is nobody known for blue color, so we'll wait for this one. The persons who like red and gray are adjacent. This means red and gray will be adjacent if this is red, because yellow is already this, so E is red. Ticket mark, this is already done. Vacant seat of row 1 is not an immediate neighbor of D. This was already consumed, ticket mark. Q sits at one of the extreme ends. R doesn't like red and gray colors. R is already fixed, and Q is does not at Q sits at one of the extreme ends. This is already settled. So 14th is also already consumed. Now let us move for other pass. Q doesn't like purple or pink. So I'll just write here a purple cross to tell me that Q can't like purple color. Like purple, pink, of course, no possibility because R is already pink. So second is also consumed. Next, now what is 11th is left. The one who likes violet faces the one who likes blue color. The issue is I can't see blue color still so far anywhere. It means I have to find blue in this whole set. Maybe I have ticked something wrongly. Let us scan it. S sits third to the right of R and likes blue. Okay, this one was skipped. We had by mistake ticked it mark. S sits third to the right and likes blue color. This means S likes blue color. So I'll paste blue here. And now I will come back to 11th. The one who likes violet faces the one who likes blue. So this means violet comes at this position. So I'll tick it mark also. And this means after ticking mark all, I still can't find colors for Q, P and T. Probably I have ticked something wrongly because such sorts of things do happen even in an examination. So let us scan for more colors here. Especially we look for T and Q. Q doesn't like purple or pink, that we have already consumed here. What about T? T who likes neither purple nor white. So P, T will not like purple and doesn't like white. This means purple is neither for this nor for this. Purple has to be for P. So we'll write purple. And then T white can't come here. And this means white will be coming at Q because that is the only one that is left. Place white. And what about the last color that is left? Last color is, I think green is not used. So green will come for T. This solves the entire puzzle. E red, D gray, B yellow, vacant, A violet, C black, T green, R pink, P purple, S blue, Q white. This is how we can, in a very, very few lines, you see, I haven't used any rough work here. This was one of the easier questions that has been asked in the recent years. So this you should keep in your mind that this is how we can crack these questions. Marks are for free. Thank you.